All right, hello and welcome to JBay TV. We're back, we're here, we're streaming a very key game in the two seasons of Noah's Ark and 21 Juke Street. This is gonna be a game of the ages. Right now, after week one, both teams are 0-2-0 with two losses, but they're looking to change that here tonight on Monarch. I'm psyched, I love the map, I love the two teams. And I am hype and ready to go. Alright, first off, let me try to find a tree so more people watch it. But thank you viewers tuning in now. And I'll be ready to get the show on the road. Make sure I have my screens ready. All right, so like always, report any audio or video problems to me in the comments or in the Twitch feed, because I need to hear about those. It takes a long time if I notice them on my own. So, without any screwing around, hope to get this link soon. I believe the starting lineup for Noah's Ark will be Mobius 1, also known as Drift. Assisting him is Clueball. They're waiting on the Mega Noob for offense, but looks like they will also have No Name filling in that second offensive spot. So, I know some of you watching, waiting, anticipating, you may get bored of my very plain loadout screen. So, you know what I like to do when there's a lonely action, games aren't getting started, when it's just me and the audience right here, is to go over some stats. And we only have 1 week of stats. But, I would like to tell you how the players did on the previous week. So as I'm looking through the stats categories, oh, finally got a group link. All I can pick out the leaders for each team. Looks like the two offensive members of 21 Juice Street, as is normal for any loss, Boosty and Mr. Fruitsy didn't do too well in their respective categories. Looks like Fruitsy pulled a 2.12 SASP-O, while Boosty did slightly better with a 2.18. On defense, the two 21 Juice Streeters would be Herky and can't find the other one. But Herky obviously didn't put up stellar numbers, having a 0.10 SASP-D. All right, so the player we were waiting for, Mega Noob, has finally arrived. And we should be ready to start. Now, if you look at team stats, it's like 21 Juice Street and Noah's Ark are both ranked 25 and 26. Just not a great sort of numbers. But it looks like they're comparable in their scores and stats on the games. This would be a great match. I better go into spec. And as we were preparing to start, I'd like to thank my music suppliers. That would be Teal, Sonic, and Buttersnack, or Snack. Also like to thank Donuts42 for the scoreboard here and in my regular scene. And yeah, I'm excited to get this game started. So, looking at these rosters, it looks like the starting lineup for Noah's Ark will be Mobius1 and Clueballs on D with Mega Noob and Ballexander on O. You should notice that there are two players that have changed their names on Noah's Ark. It's Mobius1 from Drift and Ballexander from No Name, who's also a Rules Committee administrator, if you didn't know. Now for 21 Juke Street, it looks like three of the starting four are already in. It looks like the Bob 18 and Zen Whisper appear to be on D with Boosty on O. Do not know where Mr. Fruitsy is, but I believe he'll be joining us soon. Alright, so it looks like the Rays are handed down finally from Noah's team, just waiting on 21 Juke Street to confirm. And we'll be ready to go. Are you guys hype? You guys should tell me about your day. It looks like I have only 3 viewers. So I'd like to hear you in the comments section. I just want to hear what you guys been up to, because I missed you so long. So how's your day been? How's your Tuesday night? One of the reasons I'm streaming is that I really miss NLTP Tuesdays. It's just, I don't know, it's just such a great feeling to go out and just all day be prepping for the game day or the game night. And you know, yeah, I can do other stuff, but you're just inside your head getting mentally ready. And you go out there and either do really well or really poorly, but you really feel the rhythm of the game. So I miss it. I wish I wasn't ineligible till week 5. So it looks like we're still not starting, so I could bore you with some more talking. Oh, just actually, yeah. Tell me if audio and video is fine. If the music is at a respectable level, I care about these things because I like to have my stream in high quality. All right. And again, it looks like we will be waiting on Mr. Fruitsy to come back to the group. Alright, finally looks like everyone will be together and ready to start this game, finally. Just by the way, my personal rule when I have lower than 5 viewers is to very heavily use the air horn and the telestrator. Because, really, it's all about me having fun at this point. I know you guys want to watch a quality broadcast, but I feel like you'll have more fun if I'm having fun. So I'm pulling up my ham horn app. I'll give you a little taste at the first cap so you have something to look forward to. But we are starting and we are in game. Looks like in the red will be 21 Juke Street, and in the blue is gonna be Noah's Ark.
3, 2.
The countdown has started and we're off with both teams scrambling for power-ups and the Mega Noob getting a rolling bomb. Alexander, the Juke Juice, and Boosty, the Tag Pro. Boosty is going to look for a quick grab, but the Mega Noob solos against the Bob 18 and Zen Whisperer. Can't get out, but he gets returned in this little area over here, allowing Alexander enough time to run out, but he is returned. Both teams. Both teams using those bombs as Boosty comes out mid, Drift snipes him. Mr. Fruitsy hanging around base, getting closed down, but no, he sneaks out mid. Will 21 Juke Street have the blocks? No, Mamegano with some good offensive defense puts a stop to that capping opportunity. Boosty hanging around that boost. Kuballs gets him. And they will get a reset, even though they're nowhere near base and there'll be a pup battle now as 21 Juke Streets takes all three. This is gonna be a dangerous opportunity, and Noah's Ark out. Ballexander taking the flag in base, even with that the mega pup advantage. They're able to get away. The Mega Noob dodging some spikes in that corner. He fakes, does not quite get out. Ballexander chilling around. He is going into base, a ballsy move, but he can escape. Mobius 1 and Clue Balls need to take down Mr. Fruitsy for Ballexander to get a capping attempt, as he appears to be trapped in the bottom corner. Clue Balls going in aggressively, a boosty getting the return. A full reset is one snipe away as Mobius 1 misses the snipe but gets him on the velocity change. But Mega Noob getting that power up down to the left. Another power up advantage goes to 21 Juke Street as Boosty will be out with that Juke Juice. Mega Noob, the flag pro. They're just waiting outside as Mega Noob dives in for the kiss. Mr. Fruitsy is out bottom and he's gonna try to sneak his way in. Will the blocks be there? Mr. Fruitsy shies away from the capping opportunity, allowing Mobius 1 and Ballexander to come in, but it is already too late as the offensive D of Ballexander and Mega Noob are set up. No dice for Mr. Fruitsy, who is going to get on regrab now, but Boosty is hanging around out base. Clue Ball is looking to snipe backwards, missing the snipe after the bomb gets hit. And they will close in on Boosty in that left corner. Another pup battle remains. Ballexander getting that rolling bomb. But Mr. Fruitsy is allowed to get in front of many Clue Balls. Stepping in with that Juke Juice. Smart move. Ballexander Mega Noob just forced into that spike. But Ballexander will be out. Oh, a nice bomb by 21 Juke Streets. Allows Ballexander to lose all of his forward momentum. He's just going to be juking around right now, taken out by Zen Whisper. Oh, the Bob 18! Oh, the Bob 18 filling out Snipe City. I love those boosts on Monarch. It really allows the defense to either snipe forward or backwards. Backwards, a little bit ballsy, but looks like the Bob 18 knew what he was doing. Able to get those resets with those inward-facing boosts. Now Boosty returned by Mobius 1. Ballexander is finally out as he jukes backwards to get away from Zen Whisperer. Oh, no evasion. No dice by Ballexander as the power-ups again go to 21 Juke Street. They are really dominating in power-ups, and it seems like Noah's Ark have to be this round. Game, they have to be more reactive instead of in control with the constant power-up disadvantages. Looks like Mr. Fruitsy will flaccid. Mega Noob using that boost perfectly to block out the Bob 18. He will be out bottom. No, taken out by the Bob 18. Regrab was not established, and it looks like we will have a reset once again. Mega Noob starting early on that mid pup. He is not letting 21 Juke Street get this pup advantage. Mobius 1 have him out of nowhere! Oh, Mobius 1 introducing us to Snipe City on Monarch. Boosty taking that mid pup, and he's gonna have flag pro? No, he waits for Mr. Fruitsy. Getting the grab. Clue Ball's taking him out. Boosty can't lead Mr. Fruitsy. It looks like he will have to grab as his tag pro runs out. Taken out by Clue Balls. Ballexander with the boost in, and that's gonna be the first cap of the game. And congratulations to Noah's Ark getting that first cap. Ballexander, way to capitalize on those two flaccids. Boosty looks like he panicked as his tag pro was running out. Decided to dive into the flag, and Mr. Fruitsy had nowhere to go. Great cap. Oh, crossing paths are Mr. Fruitsy and Boosty, but the handoff will allow Mr. Fruitsy to get out right. And dodge inward, taken out by Mobius War. And there'll be more pup fights. You can see pups are very, very important. Even though it hasn't worked in 21 Juke Street's favor, it looked like Noah's Ark have been technically outplaying them. As Boosty gives Mr. Fruitsy an easy grab out. Boosty in with the Tag Pro lead. This could open up another capping opportunity as Boosty with a perfect Tag Pro lead. A stark comparison to last play where Noah's Ark capped. And it looks like 21 Juke Street are on the board. Again, great tag relief by Boosty to allow Mr. Fruitsy to get that cap. The Mega Noob taken out by Zen Whisper as he tries to evade out of base. The Mega Noob already waiting on that mid-pup decides to stay. Say what you will about Noah's Ark, they seem to be getting a lot of good solo grab outs. Just as I say that, Alexander out with the solo grab. And again 21 Juke Street dominating the pups. Mr. Fruitsy out ahead of many. Oh, and Clue Balls has to get in front, which he does. Looks like Noah's Ark are all in front except for Mobius 1. Mobius 1. Oh, taken out by the Bob 18 just as he spawns. What a shame. And another cap goes to 21 Juke Street. And Mr. Fruitsy with the bomb down, hitting the corner. He will be out. This is a capping opportunity. He's going to take that boost in. No! Mobius 1 takes him out with that beeline. And Boosty with a nice boost coming from all the way across the side. Taking it in, zooming around Alexander. And the bomb kiss by Boosty. Both flags again are out. Look like Mr. Fruitsy gets that rolling bomb, giving him an extra life. And Mobius 1 not able to escape with that juke juice. Zen Whisperer with the Tag Pro just letting Mr. Fruitsy do what he wants, keeping that defenders at bay. Looks like he gets a double kill, a triple kill for Zen Whisperer. Mamega Noob still stays alive though. Clutch play by Mamega Noob with the triple kill by Zen Whisperer. And now Mobius 1 finally gets across map and gets the kill. Now Boosty's out bottom. Oh, Boosty, 2 to beat, 2 blocking. 3 to beat now as he tries to loop around, taking that boost in. Taking it to the side. Going around. There's still 2 more after the double flaccid by Noah's Ark. Alexander tries to boost bottom, but Boosty has a clear shot in. He gets that cap. Boosty, very patient, waiting for the best opportunity. With that bomb by Alexander, it looked like the time to do it as he just dove in and got the edge of the flag, securing that cap for 21 Juke Street. It is a 3-1 game. Boosty again getting those tag pros. He even has a juke juice to his name as well. Boosty waiting for Mr. Fruitsy. Juke Street, a very well-coached team, nary a technical mistake, or even so. Oh, and the Bob 18 with a great snipe, taking the team boost in. As I was saying, nary a technical mistake, and you could always see the tag pro team waiting, never going flag pro. So a very patient move, and that will round out the game. Looks like 21 Juke Street will win this half with a score of 3-1. Great playing by both sides. All right, having the scores updated. Here we go. Great half by both sides. Some comments I could make. 21 Juke Street, just monsters on those power-ups. They seem to be thinking about power-ups just as they were spawning. You'd always see them arrive at exactly the right time. and you know, swoop and get those power-ups. I didn't get the final tallies on the power-ups, but I would go out and say that they got at least twice the amount the Nova's Dark got. And that's definitely evidence in the score, with most of their caps being off of a Tagpro assisted play or just a general power-up assisted play. Noah's Ark seemed to have more of a shutdown technical game. Their defense was pretty strong, and they stopped a lot of forward motion scoring opportunities. But when 21 Juke Street kept piling them on, there wasn't much they could do. About the individual caps, Alexander had a nice one, but that was spurred on by a double flaccid by Mr. Fruitsy. It looks like the defense pairing of the Bob 18 and Zen Whisperer is good but not great. They just need a half to put them over the top, and they haven't had it yet. The Bob 18 definitely notching some key snipes to get those resets and playing some good no grab, but at the same time it seems like they're letting a lot of solo grabs out during full resets, and it's definitely hurting them if they can't keep the flag in base. And when the flag's in base, Mr. Fruitsy and Boosty, they know what to do. They know how to sneak the flag out of Noah's Ark base and get it to theirs. And we're back here with the game. Let me adjust my red and blues.
Three, two, one.
Yeah! Mega Noob gets that early tag pro, and Clueballs comes in with that juke juice. Looks like this will be an easy grab for Noah's Ark, but Zen Whisperer playing some great D on Clueballs, not allowing him to grab until the Bob 18 has spawned. Clue Balls finally gets the grab off of Omega Noob's Tag Pro expires. Clue Balls going to boost into base behind the defense. Taken out. Hits Mobius 1, allowing him to shank the no grab. Oh, and a good hit by Zen Whisperer. And the reset from 21 Juke Street's defense. Boosty with the good handoff. He's out towards the side, zooming around low Spooky, and Clue Balls boosting into base. That's an early cap, and a great cap by Boosty. Yeah. As he notched the first of the half. Looks like the contain was very much broken. And non-existent even. And Mr. Fruitsy taking Mobius 1 on a ride. And that's another cap for 21 Juke Street. A great showing by both Boosty and Mr. Fruitsy. Definitely coming down to their jukes to get around the stationary defenders, Low Spooky and Mobius 1. And Mr. Fruitsy taking that bottom. Mobius 1 with a good snipe from cross field. Boosty taking it out. Both teams flaccid in base. And two more flaccids. And the no grab holding strong, Mr. Fruitsy with that juke juice. Boosty still on that mid pup, getting it late at 43. Looks like a two juke juice offense should be enough to grab on Monarch against Mobius 1 and Low Spooky. The Bob 18 and Zen Whisperer trying to close down the Mega Noob. Bob 18 cuts in deep hard, gets him. Will the reset be there as the Bob 18 shifts right? Closing in on Clue Balls. Can he get him? Zen Whisperer with the reset. And Clue Balls gets returned. Clue Balls, he will be out towards the right. Cutting in deep. Juking out the Pop 18. Juking out Zen Whisperer. He's passed them both. What a play. Oh, and the Boosty. Boosty finally gets that flag, allowing him to kiss with Clue Balls. Clue Balls just pixels away from the defenders, a great play to give himself a scoring opportunity. But Mega Noob, missing that boost, couldn't get ahead of the Bob 18. Clue Balls is going to boost mid. Doesn't take his team boost. He will go straight into flag, but Boosty's rolling bomb kills his forward momentum. Clue Balls will be returned. Clue Balls taking the short track into regrab. But Mega Noob is just zooming around the defensive combo of the Bob 18 and Zen Whisperer. Good play by Mega Noob, just stopped. Bob 18 launching Clue Balls down to the bottom of the map. And Clue Balls with a nice boost, that's a scoring opportunity, but the eventual kiss by Mr. Fruitsy puts that to rest. Mega Noob, oh, and looks like Low Spooky has left the red team. Mega Noob trailing around is not quite past the Bob 18 and Zen Whisperer. He will dive in for pups. He gets a rolling bomb and he will try and fast track it into base. Around Boosty. Around the offensive D. Not quite diffused yet, but he will not stay in base as the Bob 18 has a juke juice and in front of many. Taken out by Mobius 1. Mr. Fruitsy. Oh, and a good boost by Mr. Fruitsy. Usually when you take this boost, you expect them to go this way, but good hitting the corner and coming back down. But Mr. Fruitsy, oh, a ballsy move by Mr. Fruitsy. Trying to look for that quick return to allow for an insta-cap. Doesn't get it, though. 21 Juke Street, very quick on the regrab train. Oh, and Mobius 1 introducing us to Snipe City. Takes the second one back, though, as Mr. Fruitsy will be ahead of many. both teams at a return for cap opportunity. Mobius 1 fills in to re-grab. Mr. Fruitsy grabbing a power-up. Clueball's grabbing a power-up. Clueball's chilling on that boost. But Mr. Fruitsy out of nowhere. Clueball's! Oh, hits the boost at the wrong direction, taking him into Zen Whisperer for that easy return. Mobius 1 and Low Spooky taking the flag carrier down as the Bob 18 is hovering around that boost. Mobius 1 and Low Spooky coming around to the sides, shutting down the Bob 18. Mr. Fruitsy will take the bomb down, taken out by Low Spooky. You see that bomb down, a good play to get out of base fast, but if there's any sort of defenders in this area, your momentum gets totally stopped at that corner. It's not a great move if you know you're going to be met with players, but if you're trying to get out fast, that's the way to go. Mr. Fruitsy dancing around those spikes, gets past Mobius 1 and Low Spooky. Mr. Fruitsy picking up a rolling bomb, a very advantageous rolling bomb. Very lucky for him to get it at that exact moment. He is defused in base. Clueball's getting around the Bob 18 by mere pixels. As he picks up a rolling bomb and charges into base, it's a return for cap opportunity, but the bomb sends him into the player boosty with the rolling bomb. And it looks like that will be an easy double tap, and a kiss sends both players out of base. The Bob 18 struggling to get that re-grab set up. Ooh, and a good snipe by Mega Noob, taking that bomb all the way across town, and taking out the FC Mobius 1. And Boosty getting the return. Mr. Fruitsy didn't get the memo, wasn't sitting on the flag. He will be zooming around and he will try to get back to base. The flag is reset, taken out by Clueballs. And they will not try to grab here. A good call as the offensive D is not quite set up. The Bob 18 by the spikes, taken out by Mobius 1. And that will be a full reset for both teams. But Clueballs taking a grab out, splitting Zen Whisperer in the Bob 18. Oh, and Zen Whisperer knows exactly where to snipe. Hits that bomb, taking the Bob 18 out. And Mega Noob. Oh, Clueballs with a nice block in that two tile wide space. Mega Noob somehow evades the spike, but eliminated in that side of the base. But Clueballs will have a chance. Clueballs walking into base. Clueballs trying to split the D, but cannot, as Mobius 1's blocks were not leftward enough. He probably should use that boost to charge into base rather than trying to walk it in between the defenders. You really need trust for that move to work. And Clueballs will be out ahead of many. And if the no grab, yes, that will be a cap for Noah's Ark. And that gives the game a 1-2 score. Great, great cap by Clueballs. And great job getting ahead of many and walking it in for the easy cap. The Bob 18 taken out by Mobius 1. Mr. Fruitsy reading the handoff well with his rolling bomb grab. He's out mid, and it looks like he is going to try and bait Mega Noob into a diffusion as Clueballs gets returned, but no, Clueballs evading those defenders. Mr. Fruitsy. Ah, and a double return. Mega Noob just chilling around that boost. One boost will leave him ahead of three. Let Zen Whisperer take it. He's out bottom, and Mr. Fruitsy gets at him. Clueballs taking it in. I don't understand why Mr. Fruitsy didn't go for that bomb. When any flag carrier is in this area, always go for those bombs. That's just some easy returns. Mobius 1 with some good offensive D for the reset. It looks like nobody was playing Reef for 21 Juke Street. Clueballs will be out. No, Boosty living up to his name, taking that boost. The short range boost. Mega Noob is trying to solo it with the rolling bomb. Will he get out? Oh no, he will not, as Zen Whisperer takes it through the bomb. And that will round out the game. Congratulations to 21 Juke Street winning the game with a score of winning the half with a score of 2-1 and winning the game with a score of 5-2. Congratulations to 21 Juke Street. All right. So we're back here. As I said before, 21 Jew Street taking the game with a score of 5-2. And it looks to be the only problem I would see in Noah's Ark's play. That one, they need to play more active contain. Be smarter around the flag and don't flaccid and don't try to dive in through the center. I wish I could actually fuck it. Never mind, can't do that. But if you see on this map of Monarch that I'm going to blow up to screen level, if you hang out in the center area, you have all that open space for juking and all that open space to juke other players. And if defenders try and contain the flag carrier in that center space, it doesn't usually work out very well, especially for a very slippery flag carrier. Definitely Boosty and Mr. Fruitsy, evidence of two flag carriers that are good at juking. And it looked like Mobius 1 and Low Spooky were not up to the task of taking the flag carrier down in that center area. What they need to do is they need to shift their focus on the outsides. They need to contain the flag carrier in the outsides, even with these spikes here. And they just haven't been doing it. You can see those two caps, those two easy caps, were a result of a direct boost from the sides to the middle. And two caps in last game, direct boost from the sides to the middle. And they were eventually juking past Mobius 1 and actually that whole team of Noah's Ark. So it looks like we might be starting soon. For any new viewers coming in, 21 Juke Street winning game one with score of 5-2. All right, it seems like a few players are ready, but the group leaders are not, so we will just be hanging out here for 5 minutes. Again, any audio video problems, report them to me. Any non-copyrighted music requests that I won't get bitched at by Twitch for playing again in the comments. Oh, actually, we're starting. So, go into the game quickly. Switching my colors around.
3, 2, 1.
We're off. And Mr. Fruitsy boosting, taking that rolling bomb quickly. He's going to try and solo grab against Balxander and the Mega Noob. He will get it. Mobius 1 with a quick grab, taken out. Oh, Doris weaving around the Bob 18 while Mr. Fruitsy taken out by Mobius 1. Mobius 1 introducing 21 Juke Street to Snipe City. So Doris just is able to weave around the spikes. Needs to get past 2 for the cap. Looks like Boosty has left the red team. They will be playing with 3 members. No time has been called. Doris taking that boost in, faking the Bob 18 out. Ooh, a good try with that corner. Oh, all right, time has been called. We will be going back to group, and nothing eventful happened in that 1 minute. It looks like Boosty has lagged out or something, and we'll be going back for either the sub or to allow Boosty to get back in the game. All right, Boosty telling the group that he needs a sec to sort out what's going on with his internet, maybe. Boosty again calling for people to wait. Man, I wish I recorded those CSVs. I'd be able to parse through them. I definitely am a very firm believer that 21 Juke Street have been dominating clubs. That's just based on what I saw and what they could use of them. Noah's Ark have been just left in the dust in terms of contain as well, and while they seem to be the most talented team, 21 Juice Street playing every opportunity perfectly, showing extreme patience in their actions, just... Oh, and we are starting. They seem to be making no mental mistakes out there, as we like to call them, where they're making, yeah, it's not a matter of them making a physical key press mistake. It's their strategy and mental game that has been very sound and allowed them to take the first game with a score of 5-2. So three, we'll be starting. We got 3 seconds left on the clock. Mr. Fruitsy, again on that boost. Both teams missing it. Ballexander finally gets that tag pro. Looks like there'll be a 2-tag pro'd offense going in for the flag. Ballexander taking it out. Bob 18 readying that snipe. Takes the bomb, hits the corner, almost getting Ballexander as Omega Noob and Mobius 1 can close down on Boosty. Mobius 1 snipes. Mobius 1 with the double snipe, taking the boost around. Taking the corner, and a great solo reset by Mobius 1 as he will go and try and touch Boosty down in that corner. Doris can't get to the bomb soon enough as Boosty takes off to the side. Boosty for round 2, and he's going to juke. Oh, that would have been a really nice cap, but Ballexander finally closes down. Noah's Ark just outnumbering 21 Juke Street in opposing base. Mr. Fruitsy with a decent bomb, and it looks like Doris will miss the snipe, but power-ups have spawned. And it looks to be a little bit of a split in terms of power-ups. Ballexander trying to dive into base, letting Mamega Noob grab. Mamega Noob will be out. If Noah's Ark can get a reset, this could be an opportunity, but Zen Whisperer comes out of nowhere. A great snipe by Zen Whisperer. Ballexander stalling down bottom, does not set up re-grab. Mr. Fruitsy taking the boost, taken out by Mobius 1. What I've been seeing from Mr. Fruitsy is that he's not taking the boost straight, like a normal Monarch player or any other player you'd see in a pub. He likes to ricochet off the walls. And Mamega Noob in for the cap. No, Boosty. They're in front of the flag. But like I was saying, Mr. Fruitsy is finding new and inventive ways to get around defenders. The defenders where he knows the position of them. Ballexander. Couldn't escape the two defenders, Mr. Fruitsy and Zen Whisperer. Mr. Fruitsy re-ups that tag pro for another 20 seconds. And both flag carriers returned. Both are out mid. This is a good opportunity for Noah's Ark, but Mobius 1 cannot catch the Bob 18. The Bob 18 juking around down bottom. Good use of that spike. Doris staying alive. No, dives into the spike as Zen Whisperer corners him in that little arena right there. And another double return. Ballexander juking around the spikes. Somehow past Zen Whisperer? No, Zen Whisperer says no to that statement. Oh, and a full reset by Zen Whisperer, showing that he can do it himself down in these two areas. But like I was saying before, it seems there's a lot more free space in the heart-shaped center of Monarch. Ballexander, this is a good opportunity. Oh, but Boosty's lawnmower combo is enough to stop him right in his tracks. Boosty. Oh, Mega Noob is cornered and he is screwed as Zen Whisperer steps up and takes him out. The Bob 18 missing pretty wholeheartedly. And the bomb causes some chaos in the middle. Ballexander is allowed to go out. And Boosty getting a little impatient there, defusing the bomb in base, but Mr. Fruitsy has an opportunity. He's got two in front, boosting towards the back of base, and he sneaks it in for another cap. What a cap by Mr. Fruitsy. Oh my god. great patience on that boost, luring the offensive D, Mega Noob, towards the back of the base, and then capitalizing through that simple juke. 21 Juke Street again on the board with a score of 1-1 here in this half. Boosty's going to try and hang out outside of base. Like I was saying before, this seems like a natural lull in play. In this area, there seems to be a lot of space to juke around, and as defenders, there's always parts of the map that you want to corner flag carriers towards. Ones that give you more of a leg up. Definitely this corner is one of those places, as there's only three choke points that defenders need to inhabit and make sure. It's similar to the two spikes on Wormy, I would say. As you can see it in practice here, Mobius 1 can't quite get the return, but does block him into the other base. Ah, Mr. Fruitsy, he's way too slippery, as Mobius 1 and Doris can't get on the same page and return him. But they do, actually, eventually. Boosty out towards the bottom. Alexander has a good chance, but no, 21 Juke Street are in front. And Mobius 1 dives into the spike in a ritual suicide action. Alexander with a great juke by the spike. Just mere pixels between him and death. The Mega Noob fakes the boost, kisses Boosty. Doris actually going to take that boost. And the Mega Noob with a killer block, which allows for another cap. And Doris, great cap by Doris. I would have to highlight that block by Mega Noob, taking that boost down to the offensive D member playing here, sending him bottom so he can sneak in for the cap. Great play by Mega Noob, and a great cap by Doris. That's one of those stories where Doris looped around here, gotten the cap, didn't go straight out as he knew that the offensive defenders would be in that area. Mobius 1 defusing that bomb, making sure that it can't be used against him. And it looks like a final full reset for both teams. Both flags were out for a long time, but now in the final 3 minutes, defenders have seemed to have gotten it together and been playing a little bit shut down here. Mega Noob leaves the blue team. Looks like they will wait for him to get back in, but pups have spawned. Boosty taking that center one. Alexander looking for that quick grab, but oh, it will be a hot sub as Clue Balls enters the game in for Mega Noob. Mr. Fruitsy taking that boost down. Mobius 1 and Alexander the only two in front. Oh, and this is an opportunity. Boosty's tag probe runs out. Mr. Fruitsy taken out by Alexander, and that will be a reset. Even with the defense out of place, it looks like 21 Juicy did not have regrab set up. And their flag will still be in baseball. Xander played like a fiddle by Zen Whisperer as he anticipates the boost. And now as power-ups spawn for the second to last time. Clue Balls outnumbered on that center one. Boosty taking the Juke Juice into base. Doris and Mobius 1. Mobius 1 doesn't get the boost, but he fakes him out, taking him towards the side. The reset can't be there, even with the double return on 21 Juke Street's offense. The triple return! As Regrab Train just too fastly set up, Mobius 1 missing the snipe, getting off that center corner. Looks like they will corner Boosty into the side. An easy return in the pocket of Monarch. Oh, and Mr. Fruitsy, again, like I said, taking those interesting boosts. This time he hit the corner and went down. Unfortunately, there was a player here, And splats. Oh, and Mr. Fruitsy getting that rolling bomb. A hard-fought battle. And the two tag pros will be split on either side. Doris, faking that boost, does not take it. And in the final 30 seconds of the game... Oh, Clue Balls meeting him halfway off the bomb boost. Great read by Clue Balls. Oh, and Boosty will take the flag. Boosty juking around Mobius 1. Boosty has nowhere to go as he backs himself into a wall, and the double return will send off this game. Finally, Noah's Ark winning a half with a score of 2-1. Seems to be they got their playing coordinated with this new lineup that will send the game into an exciting game two, half two. 2-1, favor Noah's Ark. So viewers, how you doing? How you liking this game? I'm loving it. Both teams have a lot of merit, and you can finally see Noah's Ark team pull together that half. You can see their communication was a lot better with this new lineup, as there was no silly caps that resulted from a simple boost to get ahead of three. There were definitely... Oh, and we're going back to Radius. Definitely steadfast in their offensive defense and regular defense, I believe. And back on Radius. Remind me to give both teams a plus whatever to their score so it's easier for you guys to see. But as the score is now, Noah's Ark with a one cap lead over 21 Juke Street in game two. Again, 21 Juke Street taking game one from Noah's Ark with a score 5-2. And Noah's Ark finally in the front seat for this last half. I did do my replays today. I don't think anyone missed them. Need to refine that tool from my repertoire, my streaming repertoire. But yeah, I'll be here all week. Probably take a B-team game as well. It's because, hell, I'm the streaming coordinator. I should be streaming. I should show people how it's done. That's what streaming coordinators should do. Ooh, I'm down to one viewer. Who's my one viewer? Fatal, is that you? Who's my one viewer? Please respond. Ah, whatever. I'm doing this for the recording anyway. This is some quality artistic expression, so even if nobody watches it, I'll be fine. Seriously, completely fine. Alright, back still in group chat. We are dicking around a little bit, but we should be up and running soon. 10:34. This game has lasted a full hour from the start time. So thank you, viewers, for sticking by. Alright, we'll be here. Looks like the new and improved lineup, or the new refined lineup, I don't think I can say improved, someone's getting taken out. The refined lineup for Noah's Ark will be Clue Balls, Mobius 1, Doris, and Ball Xander. Of course, Ball Xander and Clue Balls being on O, Mobius 1 and Doris being on D. And the original lineup for 21 Juke Street is Mr. Fruitsy and Boosty on O with Zen Whisper and the Bob 18 on D. I just realized I was saying his name like Zen Whisperer, but no, he's just Zen. He's just one soul whisper, Zen Whisper. Alright, we seem to be all ready. Sitting up in my chair, I'm ready to go. Alright, we have started the game. I will be switching to my regular scene for this one, but waiting on your group. Hopefully someone didn't DC out before the game even started. That'd be an inconvenience. I want to go to sleep. All right, scene starts. We're ready to go. We in here. Switching the teams, because that's how Tag Pro works.
Three and two, one.
And we're off.
Yeah!
They go for power-ups, it looks like. Noah's Ark takes an early lead. Doris out with the flag, ahead of many. He'll run into base, swimming around the defense. A flaccid, spurred. Oh, and Klubos pushes him into the spike! Oh, wow! Oh, Doris taking that flag to the base. Just some great blocking by Mobius 1 and Doris. Mobius 1 racking up the early return, and Jesus Christ, Klubos, a fucking savage block into the spike. Just killing the offensive D. That's my favorite play of the match right there. And now Clueball's zooming around, killing his teammate, but that's all good. He's the FC, he could do that. That's just how it works. Pups will spawn as Clueball's and the Bob 18 both get some very timely and fortunate rolling bombs in their name. Not defused yet, either of them. Mr. Fruitsy, good taking at the Juke Juice on chasing duties. And the double defusal will leave the Bob 18 dead. Mr. Fruitsy with the Juke Juice zooming around. Mobius 1 with Doris taking that re-grab. And Doris and Mobius 1 just, you know, faking out. Oh, and the forceful kiss by Clue Balls. And Boosty. We'll be out bottom with one juke. Can't get past. Two jukes. No, Doris closing him down, but Mobius 1 also done for in that corner. Alexander with the Juke Juice will not be able to get Mr. Fruitsy, even though he bit hard. Biting with the Juke Juice usually works, but Mr. Fruitsy way too slippery for Bogxander as he tries to take the bomb snipe out. No, doesn't work though. As of this moment, Noah's Ark has a 2-cap lead with the 2-1 game result in half one and the 1-cap lead in half two. Bogxander will be out past two. Boosty! Great boost spawn. Great boost snipe, rather. Taking the flag carrier out towards the side, and Bob 18 finally closes in on Clue Balls. He cannot escape. Oh, the Bob 18 from out of nowhere! Getting that backward snipe. I am loving those snipes on Monarch. The Bob 18 definitely calculated that snipe, knew where the flag carrier was going before he did, and was able to take him out. And the Bob 18 cleaning up with that Juke Juice, the Tag Pro, but Clue Balls is out towards the side. He can't get past Zen Whisper. Doris coming in with the Rolling Bomb Defusal. Doris is out past many. This is going to be a cap. as we see Doris run it in. Another cap for Noah's Ark. It looks good for their chances this game. And it looks like a huddle of three Noah's Ark players in here going for a little bit of a group photo as they go towards base. And Clue Ball is just slightly tapping outside the spikes. Clue Ball is picking up the flag. Clue Ball's with the boost. Clue Ball's taking that bottom. Clue Ball's is out past three. As he's gonna come down. Nope. Trails off as it looks for more power-ups for his team. Alexander, a great use of that tag pro. Both flag carriers into these spike corners, getting chased by one player. And as you can see, that usually doesn't result in returns, especially with Boosty having that juke juice. Clue Balls makes his way towards the opposite base, taken out by Zen Whisper. He made a beeline towards the other player and was there before he even thought about it. Looks like Noah's Ark is playing very smart regrab. Oh my god, and Zoa gets, and Doris gets past Zen Whisper. Holy crap. Just the pixels taking him out the wall side. And Doris is still out. Doris is still holding. Clue Balls looking to introduce Mr. Fruitsy to some of his dank snipes. Can't get there as Mr. Fruitsy times that pup perfectly. Taking it out. 21 Juice Street has a two pup lead, and Mr. Fruitsy returned. Doris's rolling bomb backlash sends him into the spike. Mobius 1 getting the return on the other side of the field. As Clue Ball's snipes goes awry, he will be bombing up bottom. Boosty and Alexander both in those spike corners. The only difference, Alexander had the chasers breathing down his neck. Clue Ball's with the bomb out, containing Boosty, and we have 4 minutes left to go in this half. Noah's Ark with a 3-cap lead in the game. Alexander and the kiss by Mr. Fruitsy, knowing his flag carrier time was at an end with some good chasing. Oh, and Doris getting the return. Boosty taking it out mid. Doris from out of nowhere gets in front using that mid boost. And a return by Doris, very clutch, as Zen Whisper was in the base with a tag pro, one that was expiring, but nonetheless a dangerous opportunity. Definitely some crisis averted by Noah's Ark. Mobius 1 swiping in too fast, but he will be in front of Boosty. Oh, and an easy return by him and Doris. And Zen Whisper reading that mid boost. Clue Balls evades and is out. He sees that rolling bomb and he wants it and he takes it. So Clue Balls will be out with the rolling bomb. Taking Boosty out. No, he dodges him. Gets defused anyway. Oh wow, what a play by Clue Balls. Completely reversing his velocity and direction and getting the split between him and Zen Whisper. Boosty coming into base. And with 2 minutes left to go, it appears that, and with a 3-cap lead for Noah's Ark, we'll see the exciting conclusion of this game. Doris taking the flag outside, Boosty bombing up bottom, taken out by Mobius 1. Doris can't quite get the split in the spike corner. Alexander with some good patience allows him to zoom past 2. And the regrab established. Alexander is free to die. Clue Ball sitting by that boost. The Bob 18 steps on it with no hesitation. Shuts him up. Now we'll see a play here by Mobius One and Boosty getting that flag pro grab. Oh, and now Ballexander is defused, but he has the flag out. Ballexander with a very precise bomb hit, allowing him to stay alive. And now with 1 minute and 15 seconds left in the game, Noah's Ark have a 3 cap advantage. Clue Balls will be out of base. But it looks like 21 Juice Street has this capping opportunity. Boosty decides to take the bottom path. He needs to run it into base if his team will have a chance of scoring 3 within the next 1 minute. But Clue Balls is out, and Clue Balls is in a return for cap situation with Mr. Fruitsy, the only bastion of defense left. But no, Zen Whisper is back for the regrab. Doris taking him out. Zen Whisper chilling around. He sees that rolling bomb out of the corner of his eye, and it's just too tempting. Dies while going for it. Boosty should be in base for the cap, but he hits that wall at the wrong direction, taking him away from the flag. He couldn't see the return. He couldn't see the return coming, and ends up missing the cap that they so desperately needed. So in the remaining 10 seconds, Clue Balls will stamp home the decider, the nail in the coffin. And Clue Balls will celebrate by boosting into a spike. And with that, Noah's Ark taking game 2. Some great playing by both sides, as I will input this into the scoreboard here. With a score of 3-0. And the final scores of the games. 5-2 in favor of 21 Juke Street for game 1, and 5-1 for Noah's Ark. A split for these two teams. I think I called that on the Bet'em sheet. There we go. Go me. All right. Thank you so much for watching. Just, a final tally on the viewers. It's like either 1 or 2, but I haven't refreshed. Thank you, 2 guys. Thank you, Liddy Lid, and Fatal, if you're still here, for commenting. I love you guys. And oh man, great games. Glad to be calling them. You'll see this on the replays thread. Check the replays thread. We need everything on the replays thread. It makes my job a lot easier. Okay, that's gonna be my sign off from now on. Post all your shit on the replays thread. Seriously. All right, finally. Okay, this is my sign off. So, I am JBebe. Here with JBe TV. We watched a great game, and I'm signing off. See you later.